car parking. A shopping mall has a large basement parking lot with parking slots painted in it along a single row. These slots are quite narrow. A compact car can fit in a single slot, but an SUV requires two slots. When a car arrives, the parking attendant guides the car to the first available slot from the beginning of the row into which the car can fit. So far, so good. First slot, he'll ask them to go. For our purpose, cars are numbered according to the order in which they arrive at the lot. For example, the first car to arrive is given a number 1, second, 2, and so on, which is fine. This numbering does not indicate whether a car is a compact or an SUV. So if you say 1, 2, 3, 4, it could be all 4 SUVs, all 4 compact, compact and SUV, all of that. The configuration of a parking lot is a sequence of the car numbers in each slot. Each single vacant slot is represented by letter V. Super. So far, so good. For instance, suppose cars numbered 1 through 5 arrive and park, where cars 1, 3 and 5 are compact, 2 and 4 are SUVs. We'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in a row. At this point, the parking lot would be described by the sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So far, so good. If cars 2 and 5 now vacate their slot, 2 is an SUV, 2 vacates the slot, there will be 2 vacant slots created. 5 will give only 1 vacant slot. The parking lot would now be described as 1VV34. There is a vacant slot here, there are vacant slots in the end. So he's not putting a V there. 1VV34. If a compact car numbered 6 arrived subsequently, then that will go and sit here. And we'll have 16V34. Subsequently followed by an SUV numbered 7, then the slot will be 16V347. Answer the following questions independently of each other. And so when I tried this question, I made one adjustment to this. When I said, look, wherever there is an SUV, and I know it is an SUV, I'm going to give it a double parking slot. And so if car number 3 is an SUV, and 1, 2, 3, 4 are not, are compact cars, I'll put as 1, 2, 3, 3, 4. That way, my mind knows that there are 2 slots being taken up by this car number 3. It will simplify life. But this does not mean 2 means compact. 3, 3 means SUV. 2 could be compact, could be SUV because I don't have enough information at that point of time. And that's something I need to remember. Let's look at this question. Initially, cars numbered 1, 2, 3 and 4 arrive, among which 1 and 4 are SUVs. 2, 3 are compact cars. So, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. Car 1 then leaves, followed by the arrivals of car 5, a compact car, and car 6, an SUV. 1 leaves, 2 vacant slots, 5 would sit there, so we'll have 5 sitting in the right first vacant slot, 6 cannot sit here, 5 vacant, 2, 3, 4, 4, 6. Then car 7, an SUV, and car 8, a compact car, arrive. Car 7 cannot sit here, car 7 has to sit here. So we'll put 5V234467. Car 8 is a compact car. 8 can sit here. So we'll have 5823446777. So it'll be 5823446777. At this moment, which among the following numbered car is parked next to car 3? Next to 3 should be. Should be, one second, next to 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3. Car 1 leaves, followed by arrival of car 5, that will go there, and car 6, an SUV. So car 6 is an SUV, so it should be 6, 6. Car 4 then leaves. I've completely missed this, so I'm going to do question number 1 again. I've completely missed one data point. So I'm going to start from this question. Let's start with question number 1 here. Initially, cars numbered 1, 2, 3 and 4 arrive, among which 1 and 4 are SUVs, while 2 and 3 are compact cars. I'm going to write this slightly differently. 1 and 4 are SUVs, 2 and 3 are compact cars. I know this for a fact. So I'm going to write it as 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. I know 1 occupies 2 slots, 4 occupies 2 slots. I can keep that in mind. Car 1 then leaves, followed by the arrivals of car 5 and car 6. 1 leaves, 2 vacant slots will come. 5 is a compact car that will come in the first slot. 6 is an SUV. So what will happen here? 5 will come here. This will be vacant. We'll have 2, 3, 4, 4, 6, 6. 6 is an SUV occupying 2 slots. 5 can sit here, but 6 cannot sit there. So far, so good. Car 4 then leaves. Car 7, an SUV, and car 8, a compact car, arrive. Car 4 leaves, 7 comes, 7 can't sit here, 7 will have to sit here. So we'll have 5V237766. And then car 8, a compact car, comes, 5827766. In their parlance, it'll be 582376. They won't say 7766. Where possible, I'm writing it so that I know that there are 2 slots occupied. But remember, that does not mean that if I put only one, there's only one slot. I know for some are definitely SUV, but those that have only one number, maybe SUV or compact, I don't know yet. That could also come in there. So let's look at this question. At this moment, which among the following numbered cars is parked next to car 3? Next to 3 should be 2 and 7. There's no 2 here. 7 sits here. We are done. Suppose the 8 cars have arrived, of which 2 have left. Also, suppose that car 4 is a compact car and car 7 is an SUV. Which of the following is a possible current configuration of the parking lot? Lovely. Let's look at this. 823V576. 7 is an SUV. So I can imagine it being 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right? And then 4 is a compact car. 7 is an SUV. So I can imagine 1 leaving and being replaced by 8 right at the end. Compact or SUV, it doesn't matter. 7 is an SUV. But there's one issue I have here. 4 being compact and therefore that not being empty. That I understand. But 7 being ahead of 6, that's going to be very tricky. And so there's got to be a slot before 6 that is free. So when 6 comes, then 7 does not go right after but goes before. 7 is an SUV, it need to be a double slot there. And that is the slot they are saying is between 5 and 6. Not possible. So this is a scenario where after 5, 6 comes, then there can be no slot in between 5 and 6. You can imagine a scenario where 5, after 6 comes, a car has left. When, then even then, it cannot be, it could not have been between 5 and 6. 7 inserting itself between 5 and 6 is very difficult. It will be very convoluted. So it's not possible. I don't even know if it's possible. Straight away, 7 between 5 and 6, very tricky. 1 replaced by 8, that I understand. 823V657. This seems okay. Let's go for this. 8 replacing 1 right at the end. Life is simple. After 7 has been parked, 8 comes here. Life is simple. 7 comes right at the end. That's also fine. And so, 8, 2, 3. So, let's start, imagine this is saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let it go till there. And then, 6 replaces one of the cars that has gone. And so, 4th slot is empty. 4th has left for sure. 4th goes away. 6th comes there. Now, we know 4 is a compact car. So, after 6 comes here, there cannot be another vacant slot, number 1. Number 2, in any case, the vacant slot cannot be before 6. It has to be after 6. This again is tricky, it's not possible. I can even imagine 823657, 4 being replaced by 6, 1 being replaced by 8, life is easy, doable. But not this. Let's go to the next one, 823V567. This is just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. First one replaced by 8. Fourth one just leaving. This is completely possible. This is a plain vanilla possibility. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 come in. Somewhere along the line, 1 and 4 leave. Eighth one comes. So after 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 come in, 6 and 7 come in, 1 leaves, 8 comes and takes the place. Somewhere along the line in between, 4 leaves, 4 is empty. This is very simple. This is very much possible. I'm going to verify to see whether this is not possible as well. V237568. And this is possible. This is going to remain vacant. That means this is slot gets empty right at the end. That is one possibility. Or this is compact and an SUV has come in. And so B237568. Right? So let's look at this. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 come in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 come in. And then 4 gets emptied. And so 4 goes away. When 7 comes in, but 7 can't sit here because 4 is a compact and 7 is an SUV. 4 being replaced by 7 is not possible because 4 is compact. It would occupy only one slot. Whereas 7 is an SUV, needs 2. Therefore, this is not possible. Number to number it matches, but compact to SUV, we have a problem. And so 1, 2, and 4 are not possible. C choice is possible. That's where we stand. Suppose the sequence at some point of time is 4, 5, 6, V3. Which of the following is not necessarily true? 4, 5, 6, V3. We should have started off with 1, 2, 3. 4 is occupying the first slot. And then immediately afterwards, 5 comes in. Then 6 comes in. Right at the end is 3. We have 1, 2, 3. After this, 4, 5, 6 have gone ahead of 3. That means to start with, 1 and 2 have left. So we can imagine 1 and 2 having taken these seats. And then once they leave, 4, 5 and 6 taking those seats are 1 and 2 being SUVs. So 1 comes in an SUV, 2 comes in an SUV, 3 comes in compact or SUV, doesn't matter. Could be 3, 3 or just 3. Then 1 leaves, 2 leaves, 4 comes, 5 comes, 6 comes, is vacant. That is possible. In fact, that's the only possibility because if 1 or 2 had not been an SUV, there have been only 3 slots. And then we could never have had this open slot. So 1 and 2 are both SUVs. 4, 5, 6 are all 3 compact cars. 3 we don't care, it could be either way. Which of the following is not necessarily true? Car 5 is a compact, this has to be true. Car 1 is an SUV, this has to be true. Car 3 is an SUV, not necessary, this is the answer. Car 3 is the final car, not coming into the picture at all. 1 and 2, the slots of 1 and 2 are taken by 4, 5, 6 and there's a vacant slot. 3 doesn't come into the picture, it may or may not be an SUV. Could be a compact car, could be an SUV. Car 4 is compact, that is for sure, that is true. Suppose that car 4 is not the first car to leave, and that the sequence at a time between the arrival of car 7 and car 8 is V7365. V7365. Which of the following statements must be false? We have V7365. Let's think about this. V7365. Car 4 is not the first car to leave. And the sequence at a time between the arrival of the car 7 and 8. So, after car 7 has arrived, this is how the situation is. Right? Definitely car 4 has left, 1 and 2 have left. Right? We know that 1 has left after 2. Right? And 2 has left at some point of time before 7 comes. So, that's why 7 is able to take that seat. Right? And 1 has left even after that. Either that or, yeah, that's the only possibility. Because if 1 had left before that and 2 had also left, whether they are compact or SUV, 1 and 7 would have taken up the first slot or first and second slots. The first one cannot be vacant. So 1 is the last car to leave. That much we know. So 7 occupying 2 slots, that is understandable, that's reasonable. Should have been SUV to SUV or compact to compact. Then 3 here, 4 here, then 5. So, if you think about it, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 come in, then 4 leaves and 6 comes and takes a slot here, 2 leaves, 7 comes and takes a slot here, that is possible. And so, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4 leaves, 6 comes in, 2 leaves, 7 comes in, and then 1 leaves, we would have this. However, in this scenario, 4 is leaving first. That's not possible. 4 leaving first is not possible. So, we cannot have a scenario where 4 is the first one to leave. So, what can we have? We definitely have 1, 2 and 4 leaving. And 1 leaving last. So, we now need to imagine a scenario where 2 is leaving before 4. But still, 6 not taking that slot. When can that happen? 2 being a compact car, and 4 being an SUV and 6 being an SUV. So I'm going to imagine that now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, and then 5 comes. Then what happens? 2 leaves, 4 leaves. So we have 1, V, 3, V, V, 6. Sorry, V, V, 5. 6 comes in. 6 is an SUV. Or we'll have, I'm going to write it down here. 1, V, 3, 6, 6, 5. Then what happens? 7 comes in. 7 is a compact car. We'll have 1, 7, 3, 6, 6, 5. Then 1 leaves. We have V, 7, 3, 6, 6, 5, which is nothing but V, 7, 3, 6, 5. So now we've got the complete sequence in which cars came, which is compact, which is SUV. Let's look at the choices. Which ones must be false? And what do we know? We know that 4 and 6 are SUVs and 2 and 7 are compact. And car 6 is a compact. Car 6 has to be an SUV. This is false. Car 2 is a compact. So must be false. So we have car 6 has to be an SUV. So car 6 is a compact. That is false. Car 2 is a compact. This is true. Car 7 is a compact. This is also true. Car 4 is an SUV. This is also true. 6 replaces 4. So 6 has to be an SUV. This one is false. The other 3 have to be true. Which must be false. That is statement A.